Alright, 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 alright. The name is Dale, doing the movie reviews for Queen and Slim, 21 Bridges, and also Black and Blue. These movie reviews are done on behalf of Audio Liquor Mag, Audio Liquor Magazine. You could say this is the dirty, corrupt, slash racist cop movie review clip. Because in one way or another, in some shape or form, all three of these movies has to do with corrupt cops. So I'm going to start off with Queen and Slim. This movie is about this man and this lady who goes on a date for the first time. And their date takes an unexpected wrong turn when they get pulled over by a police officer. And this is not spoiling anything because this is in the trailer. Slim, the guy, he ends up killing the police officer in self-defense. So then they have to go on a run from the law after that. So that's the basis of the story. And the cast consists of Danny Kaluuya, who plays Slim. He's been in movies like Get Out and Widows. Then I believe she is a newcomer. I think her name is Jodie Turner-Smith. She plays Queen. Then you got Bokeem Woodbine. He plays Uncle Earl. Uncle Earl is funny in the movie. Then you got Flea from Red Hot Chili Peppers. He's in the film as well. A few other familiar faces that you'll know. And Lena Waithe is the writer of this film. And if you're not familiar with her, she's also an actress. She's been in a few films, a few streaming series, but she's mostly known as a writer, behind the scenes type of person. She is the creator and one of the writers of The Chi, the Showtime series. If you haven't seen The Chi, you need to get up on that. The first two seasons were really good. I'm curious to see how this third season is going to shape out due to the fact that the lead in the first two seasons, Jason Mitchell, he got fired from the show. And I don't know why, I thought it was about sexual harassment. Then I'm hearing it's basically unclear why he got fired from the show at this point. But anyway, so she's the one, she's the writer of this film, Queen and Slim. And I was hearing comparisons. I was hearing folks say this is the Black Bonnie and Clyde before I actually saw the movie. And after seeing the movie, I don't think that's accurate. Because if you know anything about Bonnie and Clyde, they were bank robbers. That's what they did. That's why they were outlaws. And Queen and Slim, they were not criminals before, and I don't even consider them criminals after the fact. Even if they are on the run from the law, I just don't consider them criminals. So I don't see the comparison there. But this is an unlikely love story between two people who happen to be trying to escape the law. It's a drama slash thriller with some humor mixed in there. Has some funny moments. It deals with race relations. It deals with policing. And I heard some folks garnishing, giving it criticism for this scene with this kid. I don't want to spoil anything, but the kid does something that people just didn't see why it was put in the film, why it was written in the movie. I didn't have a problem with it because I could see something like that happening in real life. But what I did have a problem with, it was a scene where Slim does something that I don't think you would do in that situation, especially what happens with the police officer. It's something he did at this gas station. I'm like, come on now, you ain't gonna do something like that. Not after what happened, you really not gonna do something like that. So that was kind of, I ain't gonna say unbelievable, because people do stupid things, but I just didn't see no brother doing nothing like that, even if he's not streetwise or street smart. I just didn't see that happening. And then a little problem I had with Queen, her making the decision to go on a run, being that her profession would make you think she would have a wiser choice. I'm not going to give away what she did for a living before they actually was on the run, but I was like, I would think she would think that through a lot more than what she did, but I'm not going to knock it too much for that. I will give it a B+. I think it's definitely worth seeing at the theater. And now I'm going to move on to 21 Bridges. I was sleeping on this movie until my folks, Tony AG, told me check it out. He said it's better than you think, and it actually is better than I thought it would be. And the movie's about this NYPD detective played by Chadwick Boseman. Yes, Black Panther himself. He gets thrust into this citywide manhunt for a pair of cop killers. And in the process, he uncovers a massive conspiracy, like some real dirty underworld type it-ish. And it just gets crazy from that point. But the cast consists of J.K. Simmons, sorry about that. I think the guy's name is Stephen James. Taylor Kitsch, he plays one of the cop killers, and a host of others. It has the feel of a throwback action crime drama, but it's set in the present day. It's rated R, so it has a lot of gunplay, a lot of gunfights. It has a body count, but it's very entertaining. I will give it a B, and we're going to move on. I'm going to move on to Black and Blue. The movie is about a rookie New Orleans police officer who is forced to balance her identity as a black female after she witnesses two corrupt cops killing somebody from her old hood, her old neighborhood, basically murdering her. Some black folks. And Naomi Watts, she plays the young rookie, the young cop, and she's the lead. You got Frank Grillo, you got Mike Coulter, Luke Cage himself, you got Tyrese Gibson, you know, from Fast and the Furious and all that good stuff, Baby Boy, and a few others. It's an action crime drama dealing with, you know, the bad relations between blacks just living in the hood and cops who are policing those neighborhoods. It's a very entertaining flick. It has some social commentary, of course. And I actually heard this is the first major film where a black female plays the lead as a police officer, which I found that amazing. Like, it's never been a major film where a cop as the lead was a black female. That's crazy if that's true. And I, off the top of my head, I can't really think of nothing. So, it might be the case. So, I found that amazing. But it was entertaining. That movie was actually better than I thought it would be. And I would give that a B. So, definitely check that out. Also, going to do a quick recommendation. If you got Netflix and you haven't seen it, you need to see The Irishman. I love this movie. It's one of my favorite movies of the year. Joe Pesci, he kills it. He plays a character. He's been in a lot of mob flicks, but he plays a mob figure that he's never played before. Usually he's the reckless, crazy killer type in the mob flicks he's done in the past. But in this movie, he's more like the calm, chill, cerebral type of crime boss. And Robert De Niro, he does a great job. I can see him getting some Oscar nominations. Got Al Pacino playing Jimmy Hoffa. I love the beef between Jimmy Hoffa and this character named Tony Pro. I was dying laughing. It was hilarious. I can watch them having this conversation where they're going at it, each other, over and over. It has repeat value. You don't want to watch the movie again. The movie's like 3 hours and 30 minutes. And it's worth all 3 hours and 30 minutes. It's definitely not too long. And I just like all the conversations in general. Like, there's a conversation towards the end of the movie where Joe Pesci's character, I don't know who his character's name is talking to Jimmy Hoffa at this award dinner. And that's one of my favorite scenes too. I just love the dialogue. It's a lot of houses getting painted in this joint. And that's basically code for like, go kill this guy, go whack this guy. It's a great movie. I dig it. It has the, you know, the de-aging special effects to make Al Pacino and Robert De Niro and Joe Pesci look young, because it chronicles like certain years. You got when they're like in their middle ages all the way till they get old. So they do the de-aging, which I thought would throw me off the movie or take me away from the flick, but it didn't. They did a good job with that. So that's just a recommendation. If you haven't seen this on Netflix now, so check that out. Done, I'm finished. There you have it.